What's the most significant you just ducked with the wrong person moment you've witnessed or experienced? Stopped in Reno overnight while moving across the country. Had everything I own and a little beater I bought for the trip. All night I'm keeping an eye on the parking lot. There is a cop car in the lot. Sure enough, late that night I see a shady guy slowly walking along the line of parked cars scoping them out. To my surprise, he decides the cop car is the one he wants to break into. So he takes off his shirt, wraps it around his arm, and starts hitting the window with his forearm. I call the front desk and let them know what's going on. Lady says she's calling the cops. I tell her it's a cop car and ask if there is a cop staying in the hotel. She says she'll check. About 30 seconds later, a very angry man in his boxers thunders out of his room and tackles the dude. He ducked with the wrong person. My father recently told me this story about this chat who he works with driving trucks for different distributors. They have no smoking areas, since food productions etc, but this asshole decided to smoke there anyway, putting his butts out in a styrofoam cup. Anyway, after a while his truck was loaded and decided to just throw the cup out the window after getting in his truck, when a man walked past and asks him calmly to pick the cup up and put it in the bin. To which this intellectual giant of a driver says, "If it's so important, why don't you put it in the bin before driving off?" Without making much of a reaction, he picked it up, walked to the bin, then makes his way back inside. When my father gets back to the main truck depot, he sees this driver getting yelled at by his boss. Turns out there was a conference being held with some overseas members of the company and the CEO, the CEO of which was told to pick up the cup. They instantly barred the driver from the site and all associated sites, and my father's boss had to jump through hoops to not lose the contract renewal. I can't imagine the level of ecstasy that CEO would have felt during the whole situation, knowing that this prick doesn't know who he is. When I was a senior in high school, I was at some house party. There was this chick named Rachel there, a notoriously crazy bitch who was known for causing trouble anywhere she went. She was also a pretty big girl, maybe 5'9", broad shoulders. Anyway, out of nowhere she just starts screaming at another girl, Sarah, a shorter, skinny thing, who was seriously on the other side of the room doing absolutely nothing. Rachel gets up in her face, starts cursing her out, pushing her multiple times, obviously just trying to start shit for the hell of it. Rachel finally decides to throw a punch, and I shit you not, like a flash of light, Sarah just launches at Rachel, starts beating the living shit out of her face, knocks her on her ass and strong holds Rachel's hair and starts slamming her skull on the brick fireplace in the house. I think she must have knocked Rachel out for a minute, because Sarah decided she was done and just stood up and walked away. Turns out Sarah's older sister was a competitive female boxer and showed her a thing or two about fighting. Definitely the best girl fight I've ever seen. There's this old miserly looking man with a nickel who seems to just ride the subway all day. The nickel man only seems to have one purpose in his life. He sticks his hand out with a nickel on his palm and he just points it at you. It's like he's asking you to look at his plain old nickel. He's like a reverse panhandler. One night, I was coming home drunk and saw the nickel guy. He was doing his usual rounds and he came to me. He stuck out his hand and like usual you just let him be. But I was tipsy and I pulled the nickel out of his hand. Within seconds, he went from normal nickel guy to ducking crazy rip your face off yelling angry gorilla man. Till I put it back and he became normal nickel guy again. I was mortified. Apologies in advance for any grammar mistakes and the length of the story. One night, during my junior year of high school, some of my buddies came by and asked if I wanted to go to a party with them. I didn't know the person throwing the party, but I said duck it and went with them. It turned out to be one of the most surreal nights of my life. We got there and only knew a handful of people out of the 50 or so people that were there. There were a lot of people from different schools, so I knew that eventually something was going to happen. Soon after, one kid, we'll call him Ron, pulls out a gun and starts bragging about how his parents bought it for him and no one should duck with him. Then, he started pointing it at people to show off the laser sight on it. The guy throwing the party, we'll call him John, saw this and told him to stop pointing the gun at people. Ron said something like, "Fuck off. Don't tell me what to do. I do what I want. It got a little more heated. But then it all seemed to get worked out, and Ron put his gun away. About 5 minutes later, Ron had the gun out again and, trying to be slick and prove his badassery, pointed it right at John's back. When he did, John just happened to turn and look at Ron and saw the gun pointed at him. I don't remember his exact words, but John said something to the effect of, "Oh, you want to duck with me? I'll be right back." He started jogging to the house. We were in the front yard, and I told my friends, "We need to leave. This shit is about to get crazy." While John was jogging to the house, and while he was inside, Ron seemed at first confident, but then he realized he had gotten himself in a terrible situation, and started to walk quickly to his car. John was not far behind, however, and now he had a shotgun. Ron got to his car and got in, but he was blocked in and couldn't move. John walked up to the car and tapped on the window. Ron cracked the window about an inch and was crying, probably begging for his life, while John calmly talked to him. I couldn't hear what was said, but I did hear John finally say, "Stop crying. You look like a bitch." He started to walk away, but then, all of a sudden, he stopped, turned around, and shot Ron in the face with the shotgun from about 8 to 10 feet. We all thought for sure that we had just witnessed a murder and scattered like roaches when you turned the light on. I remember looking back and seeing John calmly walking back into the house while everyone was running around him. That was what freaked me out the most. His calmness. Turns out Ron lived and John was charged with attempted murder and a few other things. Ron had reconstructive surgery to repair some of the damage, but he was badly disfigured. I don't remember if John was found guilty or not, but I do remember hearing that Ron won a settlement from John's family. He bought a new Cadillac and whatever else he wanted, but he was super depressed about his disfigured face and got hammered constantly. He died in a single car drunk driving accident not too long after. I will never forget that night. Edit. Typo. I live in front of a hospital parking lot. Some guy in an expensive car cut in line. A lady in a van was super pissed off and kept honking. He got out to calm her down. She got out, ripped off her wig, and started screaming and pointing at the cancer center in trance. He looked like he wet himself and got back in his car. Still stayed where he cut in line though. My father and his brother, who are both 6 feet 6, were riding in my uncle's tiny little Chevette, and a guy road raged and chased them into a parking lot. You could almost see the guy fill his pants when they unfolded themselves out of the car. Two drunk guys were bugging this local busker, trying to get him to fight them, saying all sorts of racist stuff. The busker was black. The busker just lost it. Obviously he had to deal with a ton of drunk assholes. He picked up his guitar and hit one of the drunk guys across the face with it. I called the police when I saw it, and later got called in to give evidence against the drunk guys, who got arrested, saying that they started it. Was covering a hockey game as a sports reporter when I saw the single best retaliation of my life. In my state, if you're female and you want to play hockey with the boys, you can. Typically, the serious girl hockey players will play in these leagues because the girls only hockey leagues are shit. There was this girl named Alex who I covered since she was a freshman, and she was really good. Played since she was a kid. Was on some really good travel teams. Competed in national camps. Got a college scholarship for the sport and played 4 years in college, etc. Anyway, her junior year, I'm covering an away game at this shitty arena and her school is playing one of its rivals, so I know it's going to be a chippy game. It did not disappoint. This big tough boy notices she's a girl, or played against her before, and spends the first 2 periods basically trying to intimidate her by checking her hard into the boards whenever she has the puck, and generally doing all the things you know someone is doing to antagonize you. Now, I've seen this girl play, and I know she isn't going to tolerate that, so I just wait for the moment she snaps. It comes in the 3rd period. Asshole comes running full speed from one side of the ice to the other, and gives her one of the worst cheap shot checks I've ever seen. She hits the boards hard, lands on the ice, and the crowd yells, because the refs either didn't see it or didn't care, and the play breaks the other way, so everyone else is moving away from them. She doesn't miss a beat though. Calmly, I watch her pick herself up, and asshole hockey player must have said something to cause her to snap, because she takes her helmet off and goes his way. At this point, I can tell her thinks he's going to dismiss this sweet little girl and tell her to play with dolls or something, but he never gets the chance. She cold cocks him right in the jaw and starts beating the piss out of him. It was absolutely amazing. He must have had maybe 50 pounds on her, but she didn't care, and she beat his ass handily. And because the refs were on the other side of the ice, it took a little bit of time to break them up. She got ejected. He got ejected, but he sulked out of the arena knowing full well he got his ass kicked by a girl. It was phenomenal. Two kids, about 11 years old, were bullying this 9-year-old kid by instigating their little sister to go hit and kick him, with the threat that they would beat him with a hockey stick if he retaliated. The poor 9-year-old pleaded with them to stop, but when they wouldn't, he charged the kid with the hockey stick, took it from him, chased them off, threw the stick over the fence, and continued to saunter home. I witnessed this from about 50 feet away at age 13. It took place in about a minute, and while I was contemplating a way to help the kid out, he just took matters into his own hands like a G. That little kid was not the one to duck with. I work in a law office and regularly have to go file documents with the court. I have learned from watching one interaction not to duck with the clerks at the filing window. A lot of people probably don't know slash wouldn't believe how detailed the rules are for submitting documents to the court. There are rules regarding the type of paper you can use, the exact spacing of the heading on the paper, the exact measurements of the two hole punches at the top of the paper, etc. There are literally dozens of rules on how to format your filings. In my experience, these rules are rarely enforced. The clerks will reject documents if there are major errors, missing signatures, incorrectly filled out, etc. But will usually let things slide, like your two hole punches not being precisely 2¾ inches apart. But there was one day where I saw a clerk take sweet revenge against someone who totally had it coming. I was standing in line, waiting to file something, and a notoriously huge prick of an attorney got called up to the window. The clerk asked him something like, "I'm really sorry, Mr. Notoriously Huge Prick, but you're missing some attachment to this form." He reacted as if she had just stood from her chair, flipped him the bird, and went to shit on his mother's grave. He starts yelling about how she didn't know what the duck she was doing. A trained ape could do her job. He would be complaining to her supervisor. And on, he goes stomping away, and she looks much calmer than you would expect for someone who just got reamed out by this enormous douchebag. I get called up to her window and say something like, "I'm so sorry you had to deal with that." She replies, "It's fine. He's on my list now." I'm curious, so I ask what she means. Her response was fantastic. She says, "Mr. Notoriously Huge Prick handles a lot of family law cases. He'll be wanting to file things here, and his paperwork is bound to land on my desk for people like him." I get out the formatting sections of the rules of court, and I make sure he's followed every one of them. She points to my filing and says, "Your two hole punches look off. You see how one is higher than the other? They are supposed to be a certain distance from the top of the page. I'm not going to reject yours, but next time he drops something off at the filing box, you better believe I'm going to bust out my ruler." I say how awesome that is. But once he sees the reason his document was rejected, he'll just have an assistant fix it or whatever. She replies, "We don't have to tell him why it was rejected specifically, just that it violated some rule of formatting. He can figure that out for himself if he ever wants to have another document filed." She looked so happy. In high school, between classes, a couple of the defensive backs on our football team thought it would be funny to run full speed into the open doors to knock over the students that were leaving the classrooms. After seeing this happen a few days in a row, the football team's starting defensive tackle decided to post up behind the door. After I felt the thump of my fellow teammate hit the door, I emerged from behind the door to find him laying on the ground. I reached out a hand and helped him to his feet. Then I told him, "Hey man, you gotta watch where you're going. There's a door there." I watched a guy try to steal a girl's purse. He ran past her, grabbed onto the strap, and tried to yank it off her arm. She was a lot stronger than he'd anticipated, because she pulled the bag back and sent him sprawling onto the sidewalk. She then kicked the shit out of him, screaming at him the whole time. As this took place in Montreal, people just watched her beat him up and clapped politely. When she was done, she curtsied to the crowd, spat on him, and walked off. Please subscribe and leave a like if you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more of Reddit Universe.